Hallelujah. Anastahili sifa na utukufu. Hakuna kama yeye Bwana. Uweza wake ni wa ajabu. Thank you Lord Jesus. Anastahili Bwana. Tunapoinua mikono tunapoenda kumsifu Bwana. Wacha ukaze kuachilia moyo mbele zake. Maana hakuna mwingine kama anastahili sifa zetu jioni ya leo. Ewe Jehova, Mungu wangu, Baba yangu, umejaa uweza. Ewe Jehova, Mungu wangu, Baba yangu, umejaa uweza.
Uweza wako,
uweza wako,
uweza wako, Praise God, praise God. This is a new day. We bless the Lord for the new day and we are grateful to Him for the gift of life that we have and we appreciate the grace. Welcome to our sharing. Feel at the feet of Christ, you is joining us on this platform. We feel joy in our hearts to connect with you and trust that God who has raised you, given you life this day will also minister to you as He ministers to us. This is a season and the season is ours. We will not let it go. We will capture what is in us for us in this season. We want to pray. We want to trust God that as we go to share, something will happen in our life. Let's pray. Father, we thank you in the precious name of Jesus for the privilege you have given us to see this day. Lord, as we go to fellowship from your word, may the power that is in your word cause impact. The blessing of God. May we be strengthened. May we be lifted. May our eyes open and our ears be sensitive to hear what you have to say for us and to us for this season. Bless every hearer and give me utterance to give out your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want to read from Isaiah chapter number 56. The prophecy of Isaiah, chapter number 56. And I will be reading from verse number 6. Our topic, our sharing today is raising watchmen. Raising watchmen for God. Raising watchmen for God. Bible says also, the sons of the foreigner who joined themselves to the Lord to serve Him and to love the name of the Lord, to be His servants. Everyone who keeps from defiling the Sabbath and holds fast my covenant, even them I will bring to my holy mountain. Even them will I bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted by on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all the nations. Verse number 9. Verse 8. The Lord God who gathers the outcasts, verse 8. The Lord God who gathers the outcasts of Israel says, yet I will gather to him others, and I want us to underline others, besides those who are gathered to him. Verse number 9, all ye beasts of the field, come to devour, all you beasts in the forest. His watchmen are blind, they are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs, they cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. We will stop here. Father, we thank you once more. Use these words to open our eyes to the call and the urgency for prayer. We bless you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The scripture talks about the original call that comes for Israel, the call for Israel to be a nation out of the nations, the nation that will be standing in before God, so that God will preserve the other nations. Israel, a special nation, they were given the Sabbath. The Sabbath means worshiping God. A day when man rests from works and they align their thoughts, their minds, to think about God who has given them all that they have. Now, God worked for 6 days and he separated one day and he rested from his works. And he raised up men to have a day where they will also withdraw from the activities and they rest to think about God, to have a new focus, to have a connection with God, to reflect on what God has done. That is the meaning of Sabbath. And he says, the Sabbath shall be holy. The Sabbath shall be undefiled. The Sabbath shall be a day to purify yourself so that God can interact with man. And God raised Israel for the Sabbath. God raised Israel for the Sabbath and he gave them a temple where they were offering their offerings. And the temple was meant to be a place for sacrifices, symbolic to our bodies. That Solomon's temple was a place where Israel would take their sacrifices, the sin offering, the burnt offering, and all the offerings that they were supposed to offer to take away, you know, to take charge over what could have happened, the sin, and even the sacrifice, the burnt offerings to connect with God. It was a place of interacting with God, because Israel was a priestly nation, a holy nation for God. But the Bible talks about the urgency for God to raise others. God is raising others, and the book of Isaiah focuses on the Gentiles whom God was also raising. And he says, if the Gentile will keep himself and withdraw from other things and keep themselves undefiled, then God will also cause the Gentiles to come into the house of God. That is what we find in verse number 6 of Isaiah. Because of the urgency for prayer, Isaiah 56 verse number 6, because there is need for a new breed of people that are not complacent, because the original Israel are sleeping, they are not backing, they are not praying, they are not watching, they have gotten used to the temple and they have missed what the temple entails. And then God says, also the sons of the foreigner who join themselves to the Lord, to serve him and to love the name of the Lord, to keep his, to be his servants. Everyone who keeps from defiling the Sabbath and hold fast the covenant. Now God is talking about other people other than Israel, who will purify themselves, who will see the name of the Lord as a true name and be ready to keep the Sabbath without defiling it. God says these people will also be given a place on the mountain. Verse number 7. He says, even them I will bring to my holy mountain. And this is a call for the nations of the world that have people within them that can fear God and they are ready to be used by God. I'm speaking to somebody this morning. You are thinking about yourself as a nobody, that you cannot please God, that something cannot happen through you to save your nation, to save your family, to save your company. You feel like you are not equal to the spiritual task. I'm here to say there is a call that Isaiah was given to reflect in our days. And when you look at the prayer of Jesus in chapter number 17 of John, he prays for others who will get saved. He prays for others who will believe. He prayed for Peter, John, James, the 11, but he also prayed for other people who will believe. And those other people include you and me. We are the Gentiles who have refused to defile the Sabbath. Our bodies have become the temple of God. And the Bible says God will bring us to his holy mountain. Verse number 7 says, when even them I will bring to my holy mountain. Listen to me, brethren and people of God. It is time to step into the holy mountain of God. It is time to ascend to the mountain of God. And the Bible says, I will make them joyful in my house of prayer. Many people are not happy when it's time to pray. Many people do not enjoy hours of prayer. But there is a promise here that it will be joy in my house of prayer. May the spirit of prayer come upon us so that when it comes to prayer and fasting, when it comes to seeking the Lord, we will not be sad. We will not look at it as it's torture. It will be a joy to forsake the world, deny ourselves pleasure, and lift up our holy hands to the mountain of God and begin to call on the name of the Lord. And especially so, we the so-called Gentiles, we have received our calling, the calling of God. And before God, there is no Jew, there is no Gentile. God has given us the same spirit that he gave to the Jews. God has given unto us the spirit of sonship, the spirit of adoption. We are also sons in the kingdom of God so that we can enter the house of prayer. And the house of prayer does not mean a physical building. This is a spiritual connection where your body is a living sacrifice. And you just say to God, this period of time, I'm separating myself to hear what you have to say. I'm separating myself to do what you have called me to do. The Bible says, there will be joy in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted. May the Lord receive your body that has been given to him as a living sacrifice. In the days of Solomon, they were offering burnt offerings, but Jesus is the offering that was given for us. Jesus became a sacrifice and he gave himself to die on the cross. And because of Jesus, we are born again. Because of Jesus, we have a name. Because of Jesus, us who are supposed to be wallowing in sin, we have overcome sin because he paid the price to redeem us, to purchase us from darkness into his light. And God has not saved us to remain the same. And I'm here to say we are born again to join Jesus in prayer, to join Jesus in fellowshipping with God. God has raised us for this one reason, to stand in the gap and lift up our holy hands and pray. Paul writes to his spiritual son Timothy and he tells him, I want that all men pray all over, lifting up their holy hands to God, praying for the nations. That is a calling to go to the mountain of God. And as we begin this new season, as we begin this new year, we have to go into the presence of God and pray and seek his face. The Bible says, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations, referring to your body and my body. We have been called to lift up our holy hands and declare prayers to God, prayers of supplications, prayers of intercession, thanksgivings to God, worship and songs of power to God. We have to stand between God and the people. I know there are people who can never pray for themselves, but we are called to stand in between God and his people. We are supposed to lift up our holy hands, representing our nations to God, our families to God, our companies to God. And may God raise up others. The Bible says, I will gather others. We know there is the true Israel. In the flesh, there is the true Israel, who is also born again, praying and trusting God. But there are others, including you and including me, that are willing to yield their bodies to God and to allow the Holy Spirit to take us into the presence of God. For this is the time when God will hear our prayer and he will answer our prayer. So he says in verse 8, the Lord God who gathers the outcasts of Israel says, yet I will gather to him others besides those who are gathered to him. So Kenya, you are called to God. Uganda, you are called to God. Any other nation of the world other than Israel, we also have a door open for us to come before God and pray, to come before God and experience supernatural power, to come before God and stop evil that wants to take over nations. We have a place in God, the place of prayer. And this morning, we just want to encourage somebody who was feeling, I'm not part and parcel of prayer. You are acceptable before God. Your one day prayer will make a difference. Your 1 week prayer will make a difference. Your 1 month's prayer will make a difference. Somebody has to stand in the gap. Somebody has to lift up their holy hands to God. And could be it is you that will do it for your family. Could be it is you that will do it for your company. Could be it's you that will do it for the church where you are. Because possibly there are some people where you worship from that are not praying. And that is what we find in chapter number 9 and 10. Isaiah 56. Chapter number 9 says, all you beasts of the field, come to devour. All you beasts of the forest, his watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs. They cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. God is speaking about Israel, the true Israel in the flesh. Some of them, not all, some of them are sleeping. They were supposed to watch, but they are sleeping. They are not doing what they were called to do. They don't even believe in the Messiah. And the same is happening to the church. The church is called to pray. The church is called to stand in the gap. That is our vocation. Thank God we sing. Thank God we do everything else we do. But we are also called to stand in the gap as watchmen and pray. But many others are sleeping right now. So because of their sleep, the Bible says, all ye beasts of the field, come and devour. All you beasts in the forest, the moment you close your eyes and you are not praying, the beasts will come. Beasts are not necessarily animals. beasts are people that have no God, who are dreaming evil every time. They gather together to innovate sin. They gather together to control the world through dubious ways. I call them beasts. But the church is not gonna sleep. We refuse to sleep anymore. The Bible says, when we sleep, the beasts will come. The people who come up with innovations that would want to destroy life, we're going to stop them in the name of Jesus. We're going to believe God and stop the beasts of the world. People that have no heart for life. People that come to steal even from the poor. People that come to destroy life. They don't value life. Life is sacred. But there are men somewhere who devalue life. They rejoice in sacrificing human life. The Bible calls them beasts of the field. 2020, we saw it happen. People dying like nothing because of distractions of some kind. But we are rising up as watchmen, and we are stopping beasts from invading human life. That is only through prayer. And I'm calling the church to prayer, and I'm calling people to prayer. We should arise and pray. I also see this where men were sleeping and they were warned, don't sleep, in Matthew chapter number 26. Matthew chapter number 26, verse number 37. Matthew 26, verse 37. Bible talking about three men whom Jesus valued out of the 12. One of them is Peter, another one is John, another one is James. The Bible says, and he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee. That means James and John. And he began to be sorrowful and deeply distressed. Verse 38. Then he said to them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. Stay here and watch with me. He went a little further, fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. I just want to center myself on verse number 38. Verse number 38, three men who were supposed to watch and pray. That is Peter, James, and John. And Jesus is with heaviness because he knows church needs to pray. He knows we need to pray because the evil one is coming with men that are full of hell, coming to arrest the Son of God, coming to, you know, do what they were, it that what was written about him, to, you know, frustrate the Messiah. And he knew they were coming. Those are the men Isaiah calls beasts. Beasts are coming. People that are heartless. They were being led by Judas. They were preparing to come and arrest Jesus. But because Jesus was alert in spirit, he was alert in spirit not to allow his body not to give in to the will of God. He said, I will watch and pray so that in the midst of any attack, I will do the will of God. But he picked Peter, John, and James. And Peter, John, and James, who were supposed to watch and pray, they slept. Now I'm here to tell the church, we should wake up. Let's not be the Peter, John, and James of that time. We should not close our eyes. The Bible says, a little slumber, a little folding of hands, any slumber will cause the enemy to come like a bandit. When we see things are out of control, the watchman was not watching. But a spirit of prayer is coming upon us. And we're not going to slumber like Peter, John, and James. We're going to be alert. We're going to be awake. And we're going to pray and stop the enemy from overcoming us. The book of James, as I close, James chapter number 4. James chapter number 4. I'll be reading from verse number 9. The spirit of prayer comes to put a burden in us. The spirit of prayer lays a burden in our hearts. The Bible says, lament and mourn, and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning, and your joy to gloom. That is the calling that God has called us for. Us who are watchmen, us who are people with the stamp of heaven. The Bible says we are to lament and we are to mourn. And I want to say this, there could be nothing happening to warrant this right now. But the Bible gives us a place in the spiritual arena where we can anticipate troubles coming. And before they hit us, we anticipate. We see problems before they come. We anticipate and we lament before God and we say, let this not happen in our nation. Let this not happen in our families. Before they happen in June, before they happen in August, we are called in January to lament and to mourn and to weep and let our laughter be turned into mourning. Now I'm here to tell people, January is not a month to laugh around. January is not a month to be wallowing around in sin. No, it is a month to go to the mountain and we lament and we mourn like watchmen who are alert. Bible says in verse number 10, humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. Speak not evil one to another, brethren. He that speaketh evil of his brother and judgeth his brother speaketh evil of the law and judgeth the law. But if you judge the law, thou art not a doer of the law, but a judge. The Bible says we need to be friends to one another. It is not time to judge one another. It's not time to talk ill of one another. It is time for the church to come together. It is time to put our heads together, our minds together, and stand in the gap and watch. So my prayer this hour is, may the spirit of prayer, may the spirit of intercession, may that watchman whom God has raised and posted over a certain wall, you are watching over the wall of your family, you are watching over the wall of this nation. Don't be weak, don't be afraid, don't look back. It is you God is counting on. When I was thinking through this script, I said, geographically, there are demons are located certain places, certain nations. We call them the prince of a certain area has some lieutenants under his command who come to check, is somebody watching? If they find you not watching, they bring destruction. But we are here to say, in our geographical jurisdictions, we will not permit any demon to voice up himself. We are ready to stop any devil in any spiritual jurisdictions and geographical jurisdictions. We are to take charge. And I'm praying for the 47 counties of our country. May God raise up men and women who will see in the spiritual arena and stop every prince assigned in their area, so that there will be peace in the 47 counties of the nation and in the nations of the world. May God raise up a Daniel. May God raise up a man praying, a man standing in the gap. May God raise up people that are not given to wine, people that are not given to foods. It is not time to wine around. It is not time to food around. God is ready to use anybody to bring a change in this nation. So we need to mourn. We need to mourn. We need to lament. We need to say what happened in 2020 has no place in 2021. Let God arise, his enemies be scattered. I pray this morning, let there be a spirit of prayer coming upon families, coming upon groups of people, coming upon the church that has been in slumber. We need to arise and pray. I know there are curfews, but we need to pray through the night in our homes. I know there are challenges here and there, but we should not give an excuse. We have to arise and pray, and God will hear our prayer. So we declare that no beast will take over this country, this nation, and the nations of the world in 2021. We are standing, watching. That is why Habakkuk chapter number 2, I close with this scripture, it's the last one. Habakkuk chapter number 2, verse number 1. I will arise and go to the watchtower. Bible says, I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampart and watch to see what he will say to me and what I will answer when I am corrected. May we arise like Habakkuk with our eyes open and go to watch. That is my prayer. May we arise, stop complaining. Habakkuk in chapter 1 was complaining. But in chapter 2 he says, I will stand my watch. This is my prayer to everyone watching. May we stand our watch. May we rise to go to the mountain like Elijah. We need to go and watch. And God will reward every man who takes a burden to pray and to watch. Could be you are listening to this and you are not born again. You are wondering what language is this. The language of watching. The language of prayer. I want to tell you the truth. Everyone that is not born again is a blind watchman. You are dark. You are not aware. When terror comes, it finds you unaware. Proverbs 10:25 says, when a whirlwind strikes, the wicked perish. Anybody that is not born again, you will not see when the whirlwind comes. Last year, the whirlwind was corona. It swept many. We should not allow whirlwind to come and sweep us. When the whirlwind comes, the righteous will be an everlasting foundation. May the Lord strengthen you today that you give your life to Him. When whirlwinds come, when the wickedness of this world is maximizing, you will still remain standing. The only way is to give your life to Jesus and you make Him Lord. And if you are backslidden, don't fool with life. Life is very precious and the devil wants to destroy it. Don't fool with life. Don't think tomorrow will be there. Tomorrow may not be there. You need to give your life to Jesus. We are living in the last of the last days. And I will say not just the last of the last day. We are living the last of the very last of the days. We need to be very careful and surrender ourselves to Jesus so that we'll be quickened to see when the evil one is coming and counter him. Open your heart. Believe in Christ who died and resurrected and let him be Lord over your life. The only way is in your heart you believe that Jesus died and resurrected and you will be forgiven. You will be made righteous. And with your mouth you confess so that God identifies with your voice. Your spirit is your faith. When you speak, your faith comes to God through the vocabularies, the words you speak, and that will be salvation. If you are not born again this morning, you have a chance to give yourself to the Lord and God will raise you to be a watchman over your nation, over your family, over your life. Repeat this prayer after me. The prayer of salvation, a recruitment into the kingdom of God. Say, Lord Jesus, I repent my sins. I believe in Jesus, that he died and he resurrected. And today, I open my heart for him to come into my life and be Lord and Savior. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, you are a child of God. You are now a watchman. You have been recruited into the camp of men and women who will not be silent until there is peace in the land. The Lord bless you for that decision. Look for a church that teaches the truth and look for brethren who will strengthen you and just begin to live a godly life, a life of prayer, a life of reading the word of God, and the Lord will bless you. And I want to pray with people this hour that have been weak in prayer. You are that watchman who was sleeping. You have not been watching. You've been giving excuses when others are praying, some are fasting. It has never been a burden to you. You just need strength from God. And I'm here to pray that there will be strength in the inner man to give you power to pray. I'm believing God as I speak to you right now. Something will happen to you. Power will come right inside you. And it will be easy for you to lift your holy hands in prayer and stand in the gap and watch. Father, I bless your people. I pray that those that have been weak, they will be strong. I pray that those that have been lazing around, not watching, not standing in the gap, the spirit of prayer, the spirit of mourning and praying and lamenting before God and laboring in the spirit for the nation is coming upon them right now, that your people will be able to seek the face of the Lord. Your word says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. We come near him while he is near. Father, we pray this spirit of prayer will move in the church again. We thank you and we bless you. Bless your people in their businesses, in their families, in everything they touch. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you. I believe you are quickened enough to watch. Don't give yourself to sleep. Watch and pray and you'll win battle. The Lord bless you. We love you so much. We give you a chance to give your offering. There are numbers on your screen to help you serve God. We pray and we give like Cornelius. He loved to give and he prayed. And his prayer and his offering became a memorial to God. Some people think it's only by prayer. We also give ourselves and we give our valuable things to the kingdom of God. There is a number that will help you to do that. And the Lord will bless you. Father, bless every giver and every worshiper. And return to us at an opportune time to take away our pains. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you. The Lord do you good. See you tomorrow, the same time. Bye-bye. Oh,
ni macho.